Hey guys, this is Nasim here. I've had a lot of questions on what emulator I use, so I decided to make a video on the emulator that I use. I will go over how to optimize the emulator and my key bindings. So the emulator that I use is called LD Player, and the reason I use this emulator is because it is lighter than BlueStacks. LD Player will run more smoothly even on low-end computers. So if you have a laptop, I recommend LD Player over BlueStacks. This also has a nice function that BlueStacks lacks, which I will talk about soon. However, LD Player is infamous for installing a crypto miner on your PC. I will show you what it looks like if your emulator starts mining cryptocurrency. But I will also show you how to block everything so that they can't mine using your computer. This may look complicated if you are not familiar with computers, but I will go over every step. Just make sure you don't skip any steps. I had no problem so far, but I will take no responsibility, so install at your own risk. So I will show you what it looks like if your crypto miner starts running. If you feel sudden frame drops, click on this button to see which apps are running. As you can see here, only BDM is running for me. However, when a crypto miner is running, you will also have this test running as well. This means a crypto miner is running. I will show you how to block crypto miners, so please don't skip this video from here. If you skip the video and complain about a crypto miner is running on your computer, I will curse you for the rest of my life. Anyway, if you don't block this, your GPU will wear out really quickly. The first thing you want to check is if you have ADB running on your computer. Open the task manager and search for adb.exe. If this is not running on your computer, you don't have to worry about crypto miners. However, if this is running on your computer, or if you're still worried, you can try blocking TCP communications, which I will go after showing you how to get rid of adb.exe. First, end adb.exe and LD Player by clicking on the End Task button. Then, go to the directory that you installed LD Player in. In my case, this is under the C driver, LD Player, LD Player 4.0. You will then see an executable file named ADB. Delete this file and create a text file with the title adb.exe to create a dummy file. Right-click on this dummy file and go to Properties. Go to the Security tab, then go to Edit. Then, click Deny All Access and apply the settings. This will block any actions attempting to change this file. Now, go to your LD Player, go to Settings, Other Settings, and disable Root Permission. Now go back to Windows and go to your settings. Search Firewall and go to Windows Defender Firewall. Go to Advanced Settings. Go to Inbound Rules. Click on New Rule. Choose Port as the new rule type. Choose TCP and specific local port and type 5555-5600. Click Next and choose Block Connections. Keep clicking Next and give it whatever name you want to give it and finish it. This will block any communications that are trying to access your computer. At this point, hackers will not be able to use your computer as a crypto miner. Now, let's look at some settings to optimize LD Player's performance. The first thing to do is go to NVIDIA's control panel. I'm not sure what the exact AMD equivalents are, but I hope you can find the same settings for AMD as well. Anyway, go to 3D Settings, then Program Settings. If you open up the list, you will be able to choose Lydian LD Box. From here, turn off Vertical Sync and Shader Cache. Turn on Thread Optimization. Scroll all the way down. For the Power Management mode, choose Prefer Best Performance. Now you can close the window. Go to LD Player and go to System Apps. Go to Settings, and if you scroll all the way down, you will be able to go to About Tablet. Again, scroll all the way down and click on Build Number until you enter Developer's Mode. Go back and you will now have Developer's option. Look for Force GPU Rendering and turn this on. Now, you can go to LD Player setting and play around with some settings. These settings depend on your computer specifications, so it will be different for everyone. You can try changing the number of cores used or how much memory LD Player will use. You can also play with rate setup and resolution. I showed you my settings, but you should try different settings to see which settings work best for you. Let's go over my key bindings. This is one of the most commonly asked questions during my streams. LD Player has a preset for BDM. I will go over some important presets, then I will go over my key bindings. So a preset means you don't have to set up anything, but you can still perform everything. For example, the WASD works as your direction key as a preset. I am also used to this because of some FPS games, so this is what I use too. For the skills, the presets are on your numpad. This is what the numpad is, and these buttons are the skill buttons. The 3 key is how you can switch your skills. The next keys are your Black Spirit skills. Another good advantage about using the preset skills is that you can use the skills even if it's covered up or not shown on the screen. For example, if I use the left arrow key, I can use my Black Spirit buff. Likewise, if I use the up arrow key, I can use my Black Spirit skill. For both, I don't even have to open up my Black Spirit skills. Likewise, the down arrow key is the potion key. I think these are the most important keys that you will need, but I will share my key bindings as well. Like I mentioned, I use the preset for the D-pad, so I have no settings here. For the skills, I didn't like the presets, so I switched them to use these keys. For evasion, I use E, and to switch skills, I use the spacebar. I don't use the lock key that much, but I have a setting for it, just in case the game auto-locks onto something. I use the shift key to unlock from the wrong target. For the potions, I use the F key. All of these keys can be applied with the simple touch button. Click this keyboard, then drag the simple touch button and drop it where you want it to be. Choose the key you want to use, and you should be done. Let's go into another really important key. When playing on the keyboard, it is really hard to rotate the camera because you are not using your mouse. However, LD Player can set this up. Drag and drop the 3D view control to somewhere where no buttons will be used. You can set up keys to make the camera rotate. In my case, I usually turn the camera while moving, so I wanted it to be on my right hand. I chose N for left, M for right, U for up, and I for down. You can also play with the sensitivity, and personally, I liked 8 for this. You can customize this even more so keep playing around with it. I want to show you another powerful key that LD Player has. If you look at my X key, you can see that there is a green line under it. This imitates the drag motion. So if I tap on my X key, you can see that this opens up. Just remember that the green line remembers the speed of your drag as well. Let me explain what I mean. If I drag slowly, the saved key will also drag very slowly. If I drag quickly, when I press the key, it will also drag very quickly. So when you save this key, try to drag quickly. So I set this up so that if I press X, then C, I can switch my settings really quickly without using my mouse. I believe I went through everything I know on how to set up LD Player and key bindings, but if I missed anything, please share it with the community by leaving a comment. Also, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments as well, and I'll try to answer them when I can. All right, peace. I need to know if you'll give me a second chance. They don't come